Hi, my name is Rick Hayes with Raptor Blasting Systems, and I'm here today to show you a new product offering that we have coming to the market that is revolutionary and is unlike anything in the outdoor portable blast arena right now. Right now you have two options. You have a dry blast pot, which requires a lot of air. You have a wet blast pot, which gives you the benefit of suppressing the dust, and that requires a lot of air. Going forward, we're going to show you the system and how it's different, and I'm going to show you this in use. We actually took this system to a local fountain that is a swimming pool with a fountain inside of it. It gave us the opportunity to blast pool tiles, the calcium buildup on the pool tiles, calcium buildup on the rock that was at the water levels, and also on these pillars where the water was streaming down the pillars that had massive calcium buildup. So over the course of this video, we're going to lay some video on and show you how this system works. So there's many benefits and savings to this type of system over the typical systems that are out there right now. The biggest one and the first one I want to talk about is the fact that this system requires a tenth of the CFM to maintain the system and make it work like an outdoor blast pot. Typically with an outdoor blast pot, dry or wet, you've got to have at least 100 CFM to make that thing function at a high level. This system, you know, that means bringing a towable compressor, usually a diesel compressor 185, behind your vehicle in addition to everything else that you've got to bring out there, pot, you know, media, everything. So this system, because the pump is doing most of the action and putting the media to the nozzle, and the nozzle is accelerating the media, it only requires 17 CFM, meaning you can get away with a 10 horsepower gas-powered compressor that is going to cost you $1,300-$1,400 as opposed to $20,000. With this system, we used a gas-powered 10 horsepower compressor with a 60-gallon tank, and it literally only cost us $1,400. The thing never wavered below 120 PSI when we wanted it that high. It held that pressure, it continued to work, and it supplied this thing with air for as long as we needed it. So some of the other benefits of this system really first started with the pool tiles. I started thinking about pool tiles, and the reason being is, in a dry blast cabinet and a wet blast cabinet, the end result is very, very different. Dry blast will leave a semi-dull, open-poured finish on that product. When you add water to the mix, it has a magic way of sending the same media at the part, sending it sideways and having a polishing effect while still cleaning faster and more efficiently than dry blast. And my first thought with this was, well, pool tiles. You know, when you're doing these glass pool tiles, you really need a delicate finish that will not invade the surface and dull these finishes. And that's exactly what wet blast was doing. And so my thought was, man, if I could take the pool tiles off of the pool, bring them and blast them in there and remount them, that's the perfect scenario. And then my mind went to, no, how do we take the system to the pool? Well, this is it. And some of the benefits of the pool tile cleaning are, one, way softer on the tiles. If you blast 10 feet of tiles dry blast and then 10 feet of tiles with the wet blast, you end up with a way shinier finish that does not require you to come back it over it with a sealer to bring back that shine. The shine stays and it cleans just as fast with a little bit less media. And then the biggest benefit when it comes to the media that you're using is, you already have to get the media out of the pool, and in a dry blast system or wet blast pot, you've got to put it back into that pot. But in a dry blast system, especially, that is around the cost effectiveness of this, you know, unit, you can't reuse that media. Now, when you suck the media out of a pool after using the PoolMaster, and this thing's drained of water, that media will go through the nozzle 8 to 15 times before it's no good. You pour the media back in the tank, you take it to the next job, you fill this thing back up with water, you plug the pump in, you put it into solution, and you're reusing the media. So that being said, this is a great machine for the pool tile market. But in addition, is it just as viable for any outdoor blasting application? And the answer is yes. You can use any media, garnet, glass bead, aluminum oxide, crushed glass, disposable medias, any media as long as it doesn't float. You can prep something for powder coat and give it teeth and profile. So in other words, this same machine, if you wanted to do a car body or graffiti removal or any type of outdoor blasting that you typically do with an outdoor blasting pot, dry or wet now, you can do it with this, use much less air. So is it just a pool tile machine? No, it's a machine that will do any type of outdoor portable blasting. With a number 4 nozzle, you can maintain 110 to 120 PSI, and this tank with a half a bag of media in it will last you 45 minutes. So you get 45 minutes out of blasting out of 25 pounds to 35 pounds of media, depending on the job and how hard it is. Sometimes you might need a full bag to get 45 minutes, but that's very, very comparable to what an outdoor blast pot uses at a much, much lower price tag. Thank you for your time. And if you need more information, you can find us at raptorblaster.com, raptorblastingsolutions.com, or call us at 916-409-2458. Thank you. Have a great day.